Aloha and good morning. Welcome to Wake Up Today on this Monday. It is the 3rd of June. I'm Sam Spangler. Before we get to your top stories, we do continue with breaking news this morning. Kīlauea volcano is once again erupting on Hawaii Island. U.S. Geological Survey says the new eruption began at approximately 12:30 this morning. Joining us now with the very latest is geologist Katie Mulliken with the Hawaiian Volcano Observatory. Aloha and good morning, Katie. Thank you so much for stopping by with us this morning.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me.
Katie, I understand your team just finished a flyover. Can you give us any of the results that you folks saw?
Yeah, so we had a team of Hawaiian Volcano Observatory geologists do an overflight of the eruption site just a few minutes ago, and they reported that there was a fissure system about half a mile long. Only a portion of it was still active as of this morning, with fountains up to about 10 feet high. These fountains were feeding short lava flows just a few hundred meters from the vent locations. So this activity has decreased quite a bit already from when it first started in the early hours this morning.
Okay, and we're used to so many eruptions happening within the caldera at Halemaumau. This has happened historically, the last one in 1974, correct, that we had an eruption within this area about a mile south of the caldera.
Yes, yeah, so this eruption, the recent eruptions at Kīlauea have happened within the summit caldera. This one is actually happening on the upper southwest rift zone. So the most recent eruption in this area was in 1974. That eruption only lasted one day. Prior to that, there was an eruption in 1971 that lasted about 5 days. And before that, the most recent eruption was in 1919. That eruption lasted 8 months. So we're closely monitoring this activity. We're going to see what happens in the coming days. Typically, eruptions start really vigorous at the start and then they decrease. So we're still in this transition period where we were seeing really vigorous activity this morning and we're starting to see it slow down. So we're going to continue to monitor and see what happens as we move forward.
And we're taking a look at some of the still photos and the images that you folks had presented. Just incredible to see the glow. Now, looking south on the map, looks like downslope, there's really not a lot of things that are in the way of potential activity, which is good to see. No roads, a trail I know is closed. The Mauna Iki Trail is closed from Hawaiian Volcano National Park. Any concerns that you folks have that you'd like the public to know about?
Yeah, so this eruption is happening in a remote area of Hawaii Volcanoes National Park. Hawaii Volcanoes National Park has closed some areas as a precaution, and really the greatest hazard of concern right now might be that the volcanic gas emissions, which are increased, might cause some fog in populations downwind. So areas of Kau might experience some fog.
Yeah, always good for those folks to be cognizant of that. Just as far as the historical precedents that you folks had talked about, the 1974 eruption, that how much do you look on those historical incidents to see what might happen with the eruptions that are happening today?
Yeah, we rely on those past observations a lot. In geology, they say what happens in the past can happen in the future. So as this activity was ramping up yesterday, we were reviewing past eruptions in these areas, trying to understand what had led to eruptions in these areas and also how long they had lasted, just because that's going to help us evaluate this activity as it is ongoing and help us forecast what might happen as this activity continues.
All right, as this activity does continue, hopefully the folks that are down there visiting Hawaiian Volcanoes National Park can view so from a safe distance, but it's just a beautiful thing to say. Katie Mulliken with the USGS, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.